Hi friends, I'm Dr. Ritu Khosla, Assistant Professor in the Department of Political Science, MCMDAV College for Women, Chandigarh. The topic that I'm going to teach you today is structural approach. Now, if we talk about the approaches that we study in political science, they are namely two. The one is the traditional approach, the second one is the modern approach. Now, first talking about the traditional approach, this was the approach that was studied or that was undertaken before the outburst of the Second World War. And the main focus of this approach was on the state and the government. That is, it mainly focused on the formal structures of the government like the legislature, executive and judiciary. And moreover, this approach, it considered more of the norms and the values. It studied norms and values. It was not a scientific approach. The science, the facts was not considered at that time. So because of all these deficiencies, later on a new approach emerged. The different political scholars, they came up with a new approach, that is a modern approach. Like for example, we had the behavioralism and the post-behavioralism approach, and they used more of scientific methods. However, in this module, that is the structural approach, we will be focusing on the traditional approach. The objectives of the module are to understand the various structures, to understand the traditional approach to the study of political science, to be familiar with the various traditional approaches, to understand the working of the structures, and to study the influence of structures. The approach of comparative politics prior to the Second World War is generally known as traditional approach. Indeed, what is today called the comparative politics was studied under foreign government till the Second World War. In the traditional approaches, political analysts depended upon normative, historical and descriptive studies. The normative aspects of the study made it first determine values and then prescribe the same. The forms of value was what ought to be, then what is. The traditional approaches, be it the legal, philosophical, historical or structural, tended to express their preferences for something. They gave priority to some order and then supported it because of a higher sense of ideal or because of some universal commitment. The sense experience, which is crucial in contemporary approaches, does not find any place in the traditional approaches. A normative statement cannot be verified or repeated. The statement could be supported by strong arguments, but none could be verified. Values became very important and facts were not studied or entertained. It serves as an intrinsic value, which is an end in itself and an end different to different people. Thus, the traditional approaches are very subjective. What may be justice for one might not be justice for the other. It can define and defend but cannot prove. The traditional approaches are prescriptive, for they deal with those conditions that are prevalent and have been accepted by the society. The laws, conditions, habits are described and argued that how right or wrong they are morally, and then an alternative is prescribed. The alternative might be achievable or might not be achievable, but the best is prescribed. Nothing can be proved scientifically, but the focus was on values and in achieving what is morally considered right. Among the traditional approaches, we include the philosophical, legal, historical, structural, and institutional approaches. The philosophical approach attempts to clarify the various concepts used in various disciplines. It is considered to be the oldest approach. It describes the subject matter and the nature of the subject. The endeavor is to clear the confusion that results because of language and terms. It also tries to set the parameters for what is just, good, right or wrong. Everything is based on moral reasoning and cannot be put under the microscope of dissection. Political philosophy is an attempt to know the nature of political happenings. Once a result is attained, it can further be questioned. The debate continues. The attempt is to attain true knowledge, but the search never ends. The aim is to set up good political order. In the legal approach, the endeavor is to understand politics, political occurrences in terms of law. All the organs of the government are assigned some specific functions. The emphasis is to analyze the legal and constitutional framework. The focus is to inquire into the legal position and see how their actions are valid. The historical approach analyzes the historical events while attempting to understand politics by studying an account of the past. The ideas and the lives of the past ages is analyzed so that the present day problems can be solved. Political thought, political theory, and politics as such have a rich past. The knowledge of the past is necessary to formulate new theories. It is necessary to recapitulate the circumstances under which a political theory was produced for understanding its relevance to the present situation. Moreover, any political theory is not only a product of history, it is also served as an instrument of molding history by its ideological force. However, all great political theories are valid for all times. The traditional approach only described the various structures without comparing them. The emphasis was on studying the formal political structures and presenting a political antinomy of the countries. The governments and the structures were chosen arbitrarily. Traditional approaches were considered narrow. They only studied the structures of the advanced industrialized countries. The study of Western countries, which were sparsely populated, made the study very ethnocentric. No doubt, these governments were democratic, but the study of the Third World countries would have made it more comprehensive. Situations keep on changing, but the traditional approaches do not study the forces that assist in these changes and subsequently their effect. Ignoring of the informal organizations makes the traditional approaches lack in drive. They did not believe with the non-political actors of political behavior. Centered in European countries, the sample was very small, for the majority of the population lived in the developing countries and the latter were ignored. All this led the political scientists to develop a new branch called comparative politics. The structural approach is a part of the traditional approaches and studies the formal structure and their organization. Now students, I will be teaching you the structural approach. The society is a complex structure. There are many structures in a society like family, various educational institutions, religious institutions, etc. Each performs a particular function and has an organization. In each structure, there is a hierarchy by which the power of each office, each official is predetermined. Of course, the activities of the structures and its office holders can increase or decrease with time. Politics for a long time has been a study of the state and government. The questions worked upon were, what is a state? What are the essential elements, etc. The government was the other focus of this approach, along with its organs like legislature, executive, and judiciary. The focus of the structural approach is to delve into the organization of the government and its myriad organs. It also studies all those established organizations that affect the politics of a state. It explains the various branches of the government, their composition, and their powers. It also endeavors to identify the various levels of government like the local, state, federal, etc. It studies the interrelationships between the various levels of the government as well as within the various branches of the government, which include legislature, executive, and judiciary. The facts are elaborately described, for there is more emphasis on description. We can say that there the approaches step into the domain of empirical study, but it remains limited to this, for it tends to describe but not explain. It comes quite close to legalistic approach, though it came as a reaction in the 19th century against the historical and legalistic approaches. Structural approach thus is concerned with all those principles and ideas which run in any political organization. The general understanding among the political scientists was that the study of politics goes beyond reading legal constitutions and the laws, codes of various countries, etc. It believes that the three branches of the government, legislature, executive, and judiciary, need to be studied in detail because they are the one which deliberate, discuss, and frame laws. So the agencies, the structure that makes these laws, need to be studied in detail. Instead of analyzing their history and their legal aspect, the day-to-day functioning of these structures needs to be studied. McIver believes that structures are those forms of procedure that are established. Structures are those units through which human beings organize themselves for the attainment of certain goals. Organizing themselves into structures helps the human society to plan and execute many activities which would not be possible by individuals alone. These structures satisfy the various needs of the human society. Structures form an important ingredient of the subject matter of politics. The emphasis is on the formal aspect of the government. The structure of the society is composed of structures which are important for its individuals. This approach believes that the rules of the structures are very important to understand and to analyze any political phenomena. The individual is pushed back to the extent that the effect of the rules, whether positive or negative, on the individual is not even studied. It also concentrates on the rules of the political system. The study also endeavors to study the powers of the various structures. This approach undermines the role of the individual and emphasizes more on structures. It studies the relationship between the various groups in a society, like the political parties, the religious institutions, the various classes, etc. Each group has its own agenda, its own targets, and works earnestly to achieve them. These groups get intertwined in relationships that might challenge the government, the parties, and the various formal structures. History is sourced, and the structuralists study the past to understand the relationship in the present. In politics, a structural approach emphasizes the objective relationships between the social groups, including social classes and the state. The varying interests and the positions of these leading groups shape the overall configuration of power and provide the dynamic of political change. So this was all about the structural approach. Now we will criticize the structural approach. Structural approach is criticized on the ground that it concentrates more on the structures that are political, neglecting the political processes. In all this, the individuals who run these structures are totally neglected. It ignores the people who are responsible for running the political structures. The study is too preoccupied with the structures. Thus, the individual is relegated to the background. Moreover, the approach stresses on building an ideal society based on values. Values cannot be measured. There is no application of any scientific method. The study also neglects the political processes and all the informal groups which otherwise play a very important role in a political system. It also neglects and bypasses the study of international politics. The latter study is very important as the policies of one country directly or indirectly affect the rest of the world, especially in the present tech-savvy world. The approach is also criticized for being normative, descriptive, and idealistic. The neglect of the individual who forms the backbone of the structure makes this study biased and narrow. It is not analytical. It answers the questions what, but does not answer why. The study is limited to structures. Much happens within and outside the four walls of the structures by actors who are nowhere in the picture in this approach. It is also criticized on the grounds that its conclusions are prior deductions. The structuralist thinkers only believe in the social structure and not in the effects of culture, values, etc. At the core of structuralism is the concern with objective relationships between groups and societies. Structuralism holds that configurations of social relations shape, constrains, and empowers actors in predictable ways. Structuralism generally downplays or rejects cultural and value-based explanations of social phenomena. Likewise, structuralism opposes approaches that explain social outcomes solely or primarily in terms of psychological states, individual decision-making processes, or other individual-level characteristics. The emphasis was on historical comparison, which made it a normative study. The diachronic comparisons treated various systems like contemporary societies, but they did not help to develop a critical methodology of comparison. The traditionalists, the structuralists, treated each event as unique and studied it as an example that would be repeated elsewhere, and they would have solutions ready, but it was not sure that the event would be repeated. Okay, friends, now let us conclude what we have studied till now. We have been doing the traditional approaches with special reference to the structural approach. And these approaches, they are more of normative in nature. That is, they are based on the norms, they are based on the values. They are not scientific, they are not empirical, they are not based on facts, they are not based on reason. Now, one of the other drawbacks of the structural approach is that it mainly focuses on the structure, that is the organization of the state, the organs of the state, the legislature, executive and judiciary, and how they function. It doesn't relate to that what are the factors which affect the working of the government. So that part altogether it has been ignored. However, despite all these drawbacks, we can't ignore the significance of this approach. Though this is more of ethnocentric, but we can't ignore that the fact that we can't study the political science without studying the structure. So here this role is played, or we can say this gap is filled in by the structural approach. Thank you.